My name is Busayo. I'm going to be filming about how to get admission, how to apply for admission in Finland, especially if you want to come to study masters or if you want to study nursing. So I put up a poll last week on my Instagram page, asking people if they would like me to make a video, a detailed video about how to apply in the right way for admission. So let's go right into the video. I have some questions screenshot here. Questions from people. Let me give a background of how I started my studies here. So I came here in 2016. I came here, I got admission immediately after my service here, my NYSC in Nigeria. I'm from Nigeria, by the way. So I applied. I didn't know any country called Finland by then. I just researched and I applied to the University of Helsinki. So I applied, then I got called. I got the admission letter, and then I did okay. Before I applied, I did IELTS, that is an English test, but I heard now that now you don't have to like do IELTS if you studied in English from your country, so it's not compulsory. But by then it was compulsory, they were asking me to do it, was part of my application process. So I did it, then I passed. I sent my results to them while I was waiting for their response. So after which I got an admission letter from them. Then I used the admission letter to apply for resident permit. That was another like struggle on its own. Yeah, the resident permit was kind of difficult. I had to wait for a long time, and when I applied, I thought I did everything right. I thought I gave them the right information, but then they sent me a mail back that they denied me. Actually, the first time they said my funds were not clear, my proof of funds were not clear enough. That was why they denied me. So I had the two options then. Is it that I appeal or I apply again? So I took option two. I applied again, and it didn't take 4 weeks. The response was out, and I was given the student resident permit. I finished my master's degree in 2019. Well, if you want to hear more stories about my master's degree, then I will make another video. But this is about application to nursing specifically. So I finished my master's degree in the year 2019. Then I applied for, I used my certificate to apply for a work permit here, which I got. Then I applied for nursing studies in the University of Jyväskylä, Finland, Central Finland. So why I chose YAMK was that I couldn't speak much Finnish at the time. I would have stayed back in Helsinki if I could, but they needed me to write entrance exam in Finnish, which I couldn't. So I had to like choose a school which is far away from Helsinki that I can pass without Finnish knowledge. So fast forward, I got the admission. Now I'm in my second year studying nursing. I'll be done next year. So that's like the background story. If you want to hear more about the background story, about my studies, about what I feel, how it has been for in the past 4 years, I would make that another video. So let's go right into how to apply. So, by the way, the first thing you should do is check studyinfo.fi. Make sure you check the specific requirement of your course. It's different. Actually, here they do joint admission. So, you have the opportunity of choosing maybe 6 to 8 schools in an application, which you can choose either nursing, you can choose business, you can choose in an application. You wouldn't want to like open a new application, which it can affect your previous one. It's not like Nigeria where you can apply to different schools in different application. Here, you do your application in one joint application. So you choose any area, any field, even if it is business IT, you can like choose it in one application. So, the schools will contact you individually on how to write their entrance exam. If you are applying to nursing schools here, they are under like the same body, which is PhilIPS, and they do like one entrance exam for the whole school. So if you apply to Uvascular, you apply to Senayoki, you apply to Laperanta, you apply to Vassa, you are gonna like do one exam, one entrance exam, which you don't need to write Finnish. Their studies are in English, and you don't need to write a Finnish entrance exam. But if you apply to like Metropolia in Helsinki, if you apply Metropolia University of Applied Science, if you apply to Laurier University of Applied Science, if you apply to all universities that are closer to Helsinki, for example, Lahti, Tampere, if you apply to those schools, they are gonna like require you to write a Finnish entrance exam. But if you like go farther away from the capital city, you don't need to like write an entrance exam, and their school fee is kind of like lower than the cities that are closer to Helsinki, which is the capital city. So you would want to consider that when applying. So, I came here for I started my master's degree here, so I didn't need to write an entrance exam. I just wrote my statement of purpose, why I love Finland, why I want to study my course, which I submitted with my application. So, and I submitted my transcripts directly to the school, so I got the admission. But for nursing, it's kind of different, where you just like write, you have to write an entrance exam, and you have to like write a statement of purpose also. But the thing is, applying for nursing here, it doesn't matter which field you are. Even if you are from a law field, even if you have studied business before, it doesn't matter which background you have, because here they need a lot of nurses actually. So they are looking for you. They are looking for you, and a lot of people like from different area are actually practicing as a nurse here. So far you pass their entrance exam, and the entrance exam is like this. It's divided into like three parts. You write, you will do the mathematics, the essay, the comprehension part, you will write it down. Now they do it online, so like I think it's an online-based test where they just like they write it on Zoom, so they send you the link to the online exam. While the second part is where you like discuss, they will give you a topic of discussion in nursing to talk about. Probably they tell you, okay, how has technology affected nursing practice? So that was kind of the question they gave me during my own interview. So like we're like three students that came for entrance exam together. So we're like three students sitting down, then we discussed in front of the examiners. So there were like three teachers also. They were grading us while we discussed. So after then, I think the result of our exam came out in July. We wrote the exam in March, if I'm right. Yeah, March. Then the result came out in June. Yes, the result came out, the admission letter came out in June. So I started in August, end of August to 2019. That was when I started my nursing studies. So since then, it has been a journey. So I'll kind of like answer some questions that I got. So this person is asking that how many times students are being admitted in UAS per year. So I think it's one time if you're like an international student, but if you're here and you are trying to, there are supplementary admission which is always open sometimes. If probably you are in Finland and you want to transfer from one school to another, as a, like one nursing school to another, probably you want to move from Jyväskylä to Helsinki. Yeah, that's what the supplementary admission is made for. And also there are some students that are on the waiting list that they couldn't get like a response from them the first time. So that's what the supplementary admission is about. So instead of starting in August, fall, you start in spring semester, which is January. So that's the answer for that. So someone is asking me here that what subjects do they require on the school leaving certificate, because I do not have any science or maths for A level. So here I think you have to have mathematics at least on your A levels. Then I think language, whatever language you speak, also that is an important requirement, and probably English also. But all of that courses doesn't matter if you don't have biology or physics or chemistry, just pass the entrance exam. So I would like to study, someone asked that, I would like to study nursing in Finland, but I'm a little scared seeing that I'm horrible with languages. Could you please help me with some schools that don't require that I speak Finnish? Okay, so this I've said before that you don't, if you don't speak Finnish yet, you can apply to schools that are farther away from Helsinki. You can apply to Jyväskylä University of Applied Science, which is my school. You can apply to Senayuki University of Applied Science. You can apply to like Lappeenranta University of Applied Science. And you can apply to schools in Eastern Finland, schools in Pori. You can apply to those schools, and they are cheaper. They are like 4,000, 5,000 per year, per section. So that is that. Then someone is asking, which educational system do you prefer, or is it better between that of Nigeria and Finland? I think this question is obvious. I prefer the educational system here, because here it's not about read and pass. No, it's about, do you know what they are really teaching you? It's about, and for nurses, we do like, we don't do much of coursework, we do a lot of practice. You are always in the hospital, from one hospital to another, from different area of nursing to another. So that when you graduate, you are now confident to know, okay, I will go to mental health practice, or I want to study surgery, I want to be a surgical nurse, or I want to be an anesthesia nurse. So you have the opportunity to go to different areas to know which one you prefer. And by the way, do not make the mistake of opening two or more. Do not make that mistake of opening two or more joint application. Just open one, because they will delete the previous ones and they will leave the last one. Do not make that mistake. And what else? Like, I think Finland is easy to get admitted to compared to other countries. But the issue now is when you apply for resident permit, it's kind of like it's a hustle because of the rigorous process that is involved. You have to have some money to your account, you have to have a sponsor, they have to know that okay, you're not coming here to be broke. So you have to like make that visible for them, enough for them, and it's slow. So you have to start early. Sometimes I've seen some people that they denied for 1 year, and the following year they answered them. So here the thing is, even if your resident permit doesn't get ready earlier, you can contact the school and they will defer your admission till your resident permit is ready. So here is kind of like, okay, the coming to Finland depends on the immigration, not even the school part is even the easiest. So immigration is the one that like delays a lot of people. So you would want to consider that and apply early. And I would advise that you get everything ready, so nothing is delaying you from your own part. Like you're on your own part, you are ready. You have your sponsor, you have your the money that is required of you, and you can check the requirements and the money that they require for a student on immigrationfinland.fi. Yeah, so you can like check the requirement for student there and the amount they required of you to have. Yeah, and you should get your payslip, the sponsor's payslip ready, or if the sponsor is a business person, you should get every document ready so that nothing is delaying you. Then it's now the like depends on who is going to like decide on your case. Depends on the person to now act early or faster on your decision making. And also here it's not like when you get here you land a job immediately. No, it doesn't work like that. So you have to get some money ready to survive for like 2 to 3 months, then you can survive on your own. I think that if you get like pocket money to survive for like if you've paid your first year admission, then you can work to pay your second year admission, because as a student you have the opportunity to work. Yes, you have the opportunity to work 21 hours per week, and during summer you can work as long as you want. There is no restriction during summer, and there are jobs here for immigrants that you can work, but they are non-skilled jobs, not really skilled ones. So you have to like think about that. Are you ready? That's when you're making decision about Finland, think about that. Okay, I'm coming to a country where they don't speak English. Their first language is Finnish, second language is Swedish. So English is still like maybe third or fourth language. So you should consider that. And it's not like when you come, oh, you start living large, you start living the life. No, if you come with that mentality, you'll be disappointed. So just get ready. And I think considering other countries, Finland is one of the cheapest tuition fee country to come to. So I think you'll be fine here if you come. That is, if you want to know, I will end here. If you want to know more information about like my journey here in Finland, how I feel about my about the education system, how I've like moved from masters in biotechnology to bachelor's in registered nursing. So comment, like, subscribe, and say in the comment section if you want more information. Thank you. Bye.